In this video, I'll show you the differences between the last three major styles of the Viking Age and how the knotwork and interlacing patterns differentiate from style to style. Let's get into it. The most typical loop pattern of the Mammen style is curly loops in combination with some S shapes. For the Ringerike style, we also see curly loops, but in combination with figure of eight loops. The figure of eight loop is the predominant loop pattern of the Urnes style. When we look at how the loop patterns of the styles are used, we see that in the Mammen style, the loops are a series of separate loops, which is also partly true for the Ringerike style, but in the Ringerike style we also see pretzel knot loops, which is in essence a curly loop where the loops are intersecting. In the Urnes style we also see a series of loops, though here we have figure of eight loops instead of curly loops. And the ends of the ribbons are curling inwards towards the neighboring loops. In application, this looks for the Mammen style something like this, with curly loops and a separate loops, curly loops. And in the Urnes style, we have a series of loops, sometimes intersecting. On a more compositional level, the Mammen style has a series of ribbons, each intersecting each other, creating a varied intersecting pattern with wavy ribbons, curly and wavy ribbons. And in the Ringerike style, we have a little more controlled layout, often consisting of some more controlled elements, like a figure of eight loop with some more curly loop dominated elements intersecting. And in the Urnes style, we have layers of ribbons, a figure of eight loops. So there you have it. These are the core concepts of how the ribbons are used in the three late Viking Age styles. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next video.